does not come from physical capacity. It comes from indomitable will. A very warm welcome to one and all. Live as if you were to die tomorrow. Learn as if you were to live forever, said Mahatma Gandhi. Today, we gather here to celebrate Gandhi Jayanti, an event kept to mark the birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. Let's celebrate that day with invocating prayer song. I welcome Lakshmi Shubha ma'am for the prayer.
Om Tat Sat Shri Narayanan Ni Purushottama Guru Ni Siddha Buddhan Ni Skanda Vinayaga Savita Pavagan Ni Savita Pavagan Ni Brahmamas जितनी येषु पिता प्रभुनी रुद्र विष्णुनी राम कृष्णनी रहीमतावोनी वासुदेव को विश्वरूपनी रहीमतावोनी अद्वितीयनी अकाल निर्भयन आत्मलिंग शिवन्नी ओम तत् सत् श्री नारायणनी पुरुषोत्तम गुरुनी रुद्र विष्णुनी राम कृष्णनी रहीमतावोनी
थैंक यू मैम महात्मा गांधी 151st बर्थ एनिवर्सरी ऑन अक्टूबर 2nd रिमाइंड्स द वर्ल्ड ऑफ द टाइमलेसनेस ऑफ हिज आइडियल्स. In order to mark the celebration, Chinmaya Vidyalaya Artugal is conducting a quiz competition related to Gandhi Jayanti. We have 14 members in the competition: Arjun and Aryan of Team Sabarmati, Rajalakshmi and Mahalakshmi of Team Chambaran, Bhavana and Bhagya of Team Kheda, and finally Raya and Shreya of Team Swaraj. I wish all the team members best of luck and hand over the stage to Jyotsna.
Hari Om, I am Jyotsna D from 12A and I will be your quiz master. So I want you all to be super responsive, okay? Okay, so I'll first go over the rules. It would be 3 rounds and each round would eliminate one team. Okay, so the first round would have 8 MCQ questions. And so there would be 2 questions for each team. If you answer right, you will get 2 points. And if you pass the question and someone else answers, they would get 1 point. You can either pass or give an answer. There won't be any negative marking. Okay. So second round would have 6 questions of a picture. You will have to guess who, what, or where it is from. And if you answer right, you will get 3 points. If pass, you get 1 point. Okay. The third and final round would be rapid fire. Only 2 teams would be there. So each team will get 10 questions and 1 minute to answer. Whichever team answers most questions in 1 minute will win. I hope it's clear.
Yes.
Okay, so let's go with round 1. Choose. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, so first question is for Team Sabarmati, Aryan and Arjun.
Yes.
In South Africa, Gandhiji was unceremoniously thrown off a train compartment reserved for white people. Which place was he thrown off in? Option 1, Johannesburg. Option 2, Transvaal. Option 3, Pietermaritzburg. And option 4, Rustenburg. You may answer.
Pietermaritzburg.
Yes, that's the right answer. You get 2 points. So next question is for Team Chambaran. Which year did Gandhiji discard his clothes and adopt the dhoti as a symbol for identifying with the poor? So options 1920, 1921, 1930, 1931. 1921. Yes, that's the right answer. Congrats. So next, Team Kheda.
Yes.
Which of these flags were proposed by Gandhiji in 1921 to the Indian National Congress? Bhagi and Bhavana.
Option 3.
Unfortunately, it's the wrong answer. The answer is the first flag. It was designed by someone when Gandhiji asked them to do so. And in this, the white stands for all the religions, red stands for Hinduism, and green stands for Muslims. Okay? So unfortunately, you won't get the marks. So we are moving on to the next slide for Team Swaraj. Shreya and Riya. Okay, so Gandhiji's first speech in India was only a trailer of what was coming. Here's what he said. It is a matter of deep humiliation and shame for us that I am compelled this evening under the shadow of this great college in the sacred city to address my countrymen in a language that is foreign to me. Where was this speech conducted? Lucknow, Banaras, Ahmedabad, Chambaran.
Ahmedabad.
Are you sure?
Ahmedabad.
Unfortunately, it's also wrong. The answer is Banaras. He made this speech in 1916 when he went to the Banaras University to give a speech. So the Viceroy was also there, so he couldn't speak in Hindi. So he showed his regret by telling this, as he didn't want to speak English in his own country. Okay, I hope you will remember this next time. Okay, so next question is again for Swaraj. Okay, as a part of which movement did Gandhiji visit Kerala for the first time? Option 1, Khilafat Agitation. Option 2.
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Actually, he visited Kerala for the first time for Khilafat Agitation. After that only he came for Vaikam Satyagraha. So he came here for the first time on Khilafat Agitation to inform people about why Hindus and Muslims should come together to defeat the British. So unfortunately, you won't get the point again. So moving on to Team Kheda. Okay. Which of these books were not written by Gandhiji? Not. Option 1, Hind Swaraj. Option 2, Nonviolent Resistance. Option 3, Way to God. And option 4, Prisoner of Hope. If you don't know, you can pass.
Option 4.
Yes. Yeah, it's the right answer. It was actually written by Judith M. Brown and was published in 1981-89. It's about Gandhiji's life, but it's not written by him. The other three books are written by him. So you get 2 points.
Okay.
Next, Team Chambaran. I'll show you a video and you have to guess where this is from. Here's the video clip. So, which event is this video clip from? Salt March, Chambaran Movement, Non-Cooperation Movement, or Kheda Satyagraha? This is for Team Chambaran.
Can you play this video again?
Okay. Thank you. Okay, so that's the video.
Salt match?
Yes, that's the right answer. So you get 2 points. Next question is for Sabarmati. Where did Gandhiji learn law? Option 1, Banaras University. Option 2, University College of London. Option 3, Samaldas College. And option 4, Inner Temple.
Inner Temple.
Are you sure? Okay, so he actually learned law in University College of London. After that, he was recruited to Inner Temple to work as a barrister. He worked as a lawyer in Inner Temple, but he studied law in University College of London. So that's the end of round one. I'll display the scores in a few seconds. Okay, so from the scoreboard, Chambaran is leading with 4 points. Sabarmati and Keda have a tie with 2 points, and unfortunately Swaraj got no points. So Sabarmati, Chambaran and Keda move to the next round. Swaraj, best of luck next time. Never stop learning. Okay.
Okay.
So now we move on to round two. I hope you are ready. Round two is recognized. So you will be shown a picture and you have to guess what, who or where this place is from. The first question would go to Team Sabarmati. Question number one. Guess who? He's been referred as Gandhiji's Boswell, a Plato to Gandhi's Socrates, as well as an Ananda to Gandhi's Buddha. Who is he?
Mahadev Desai.
Yes, that's right. So you get 3 points. So Mahadev Desai was also Mahatma Gandhi's personal secretary, and he also translated Gandhiji's autobiography from Gujarati to English. I hope you know that. Okay, so next question. Okay, guess where? This is the Can you repeat? I can't hear.
Ahmedabad.
Okay, so that's the wrong answer. It's found in Patna. It is 22 meter high and was made by Ram Sudhar and his team. And it's placed in the western end of Gandhi Maidan. So you won't get any point this time. So next time. So next question is for Keda. Okay, guess what? This is Manu, his 18-year-old grandniece, and then Abba, the wife of Gandhiji's grand nephew, Kanu Gandhi. What is the popular nickname he gave them? This is for Team Keda.
Can you repeat the question?
Okay, so he gave these two girls a nickname. What is the nickname he gave them?
Pass the question.
Okay, so it goes to Team Chambaran if you want to answer.
Okay.
சம்பாரன். Do you have an answer?
Is it Agaben?
No. So, Team Sabarmati, would you like to try?
Is it my walking sticks?
Yeah, exactly. So, you will get 1 point. So, he called them his walking sticks. It's really clear from the picture. So, next question is for Keda.
Okay.
Guess who? This is the actor who played Gandhiji in the famous 1982 film Gandhi. What's his name? You have to name this actor. Can you still not see?
Yes. But we don't know the answer of this question.
Okay, so I'll pass it to Team Shambharat. Team Shambharat, do you know the answer?
No, we don't know.
So, Team Sabarmati?
Ben Kingsley.
Yes, that's right. So, his name is Ben Kingsley and he got the Academy Award for Best Actor, Golden Globe Award for Best Actor and so many more awards due to his role of Gandhi in this film. Okay, so Sabarmati will get 1 point. And the next question is again to Sabarmati. Next slide. Okay. So this is the place of Mohandas Gandhi's ashram and his residence from 1936 to his death in 1948. What's this place called? Oh, what's this ashram called?
Sevagram in Wardha.
Yes, that's right. So, next question to Team Shambharat. Okay. This is a really simple question. Who is this person? He's related to Gandhiji. Shambharat.
His father, Karamchand Gandhi.
Yes, that's right. That's his father, Karamchand Uttamchand Gandhi. He was a Diwan and also known as Kaba Gandhi. Okay, so you'll get 3 points. And with that, round 2 ends. So, Team Sabarmati has a total of 8 points and Shambharat has a total of 3 points. So, these two qualify for the final round. Congrats and Keda, next time, better luck.
Okay,
so... last round. Which team would like to go first? You will have 10 questions and 1 minute to answer all of them. So I'll let Team Shambharat go first. Okay, are you ready?
Yes.
You'll have to start answering once I say go.
Okay.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, go.
He was 78 years when he was shot and he was from Port Bandar of Gujarat and...
If you don't know the answer, skip to the next question.
Okay. In which magazine? In...
Well,
30 seconds more. Fifth question. It is known as Non-Violent Day, which is celebrated as the which is celebrated on 30 January. The non-violent movement was launched on 1921.
Okay, next.
He spelled word hydrogen as a child. And the autobiography of Gandhi is known as the story we experienced with...
Time up. So, you answered What? You answered three questions right and one wrong. Non-cooperation was actually started in 1920. So I'll tell you the answers. Gandhiji was 78. He is from Porbandar. The magazine is called Time and he named him that in 1930. Mata's Day is the day we celebrate on 30th January. Non-cooperation movement in 1920. He was nominated for Nobel Peace Prize 5 times. And the UN General Assembly declared his birthday as International Day of Non-Violence. The word he spelled wrong as a child was kettle. K-E-T-T-L-E. And the last one, the story of my experiments with truth. So you get 3 points. Okay, so next, rapid fire set 2-4, team Sabarmati. Okay, when I say start, you may begin. 1, 2, 3, start.
First question, Tagore, Rabindranath Tagore. Second question, 13. Third question, Transvaal. Fifth question, Nadurang Vinayaga Godse.
Okay.
Sixth question, Harilal. Seventh question. Eighth question, 1915.
Okay.
Ninth question, Birla Mandir.
Okay.
Tenth question, Harijan.
Okay. You answered 7 questions correct in 53 seconds. So that's a big deal. Congrats. So Team Chambaran got 3 points and Team Sabarmati got 7 points. I would like to congratulate Team Sabarmati. You won. Congrats.
Thank you.
And so with that, our quiz ends. I would like to thank you all for participating and do your best. You only learn from mistakes, so next time you will be more informed whenever you participate. So this quiz was only helping you to learn more and find where you didn't learn and to learn more for the next time. I hope you enjoyed this quiz.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Good afternoon to the
all
respected vice principal, invited teachers and my dear friends. Once a great man whispered, feeling thankfulness and not expressing it is like wrapping a present and not giving it. So today I take the opportunity to put all my gratitude into words. First of all, I would like to thank Preeta ma'am for giving me an opportunity to speak on this auspicious occasion. And it is a matter of honor for me. I have been fortunate to be assisted by our principal Lakshmi ma'am. You have been a constant support and you have given us a lot of encouragement. School programs can only be completed with your presence and inspiring words. Thank you so much, ma'am. I would also like to express my heartfelt gratitude to all the team members who have shown their extraordinary interest in the program. My special acknowledgement to the quiz master, Josna of 12, for conducting the quiz in a vibrant manner. I would also like to thank the teachers for the support and contribution in this ceremony. I once again thank everyone for making this program successful. And here we wind up the show by chanting Purnamadam.
पूर्णमद पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमाधाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शांति शांति शांतिः। हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरि ओम।
थैंक यू सो मच।